Blackstone Audiobooks is pleased to present The Legend of the Wandering King by Laura Gallego García, read by Patrick Fraley and directed by Hilary Huber.
Every warrior of the light has, at some time in the past, lied to and betrayed someone. Every warrior of the light has trodden a path that was not his. Every warrior of the light has, at least once, believed that he was not a warrior of the light. That is why he is a warrior of the light, because he has been through all this and yet has never lost hope of being better than he is. Paulo Coelho, Warrior of the Light, Emmanuel. Before the days of Muhammad and Islam, Arabia was a land of mystery and legend. In that era, which the Arabs call Jahiliya, or the time of ignorance, everything was possible because the only rules of behavior were those of honor and love. And honor and love break all the rules. In those days, a city was barely a large-sized village beside an oasis. The primal spirits of the desert called jinns could catch an unwary traveler by surprise around any bend. The whole earth possessed a special magic, and every Arab was a poet at heart. In those mythical days, there lived a man of whom nothing remains but jumbled fragments of legend, a man who set out on an epic search and came to be called the Wandering King. This is his story. Prologue, The Condemned Man. The Saluk dismounted with a graceful leap and unsheathed his sword. But Walid made no move to defend himself. He stood calm and still and waited for death. "I swore that I would kill you if you crossed my path again," the Saluk said.
"I remember," said Walid, "and I accept my fate."
The other paused. "I hardly know what to call you. Are you brave, or are you now completely mad?"
"Perhaps I am both," Walid answered.
The Saluk did not reply, but raised his sword above his motionless opponent. Their eyes met, and in the horseman's gaze there was a steely flash that Walid knew very well. The sword blade shone a moment in the blazing desert sun. Then Walid saw the sword descend toward him and sink into his chest. As he fell to the sand, clasping the bloody wound, his life passed again before his eyes. Once more he saw the place where he had been born and spent his youth, a high-walled palace in Dat Kahal, the city of seven towers, a small refuge of green in the middle of a seemingly endless desert, the palace where his glory and legend and shame had taken shape and grown. Chapter 1. The Prince. Everyone said that Walid ibn Hojr, Prince of Kinda, had been touched by a jinn at the moment of his birth. Handsome of body and fair of soul, generous as a rush of water, he never held back his gifts when it came to pleasing his beloved people, whom he treated with magnanimity and justice. At the age of 17, he was a perfect courtier, gracious and elegant, fluent in several tongues, and blessed with remarkable tact and diplomacy. Whether serving abroad as an ambassador or hosting emissaries from far-off lands, Walid ibn Hojr managed his political duties with a fine and subtle skill. And his skills at war? He mounted a horse as if he'd been born for that purpose, and his talent with a sword was legendary. When it came to defending his land from plunderers or the warriors of rival kingdoms, he could cross the desert on horseback like a ray of light in the starry sky. Anyone who had seen him in the pitch of battle said that Walid was like a lion, magnificent and untamable. The Prince of Kinda was young, poised, gallant, generous, witty, intelligent, brave, and skilled at war, but he was also a man of culture. All of his gifts had created in him an insatiable desire for knowledge. And Walid ibn...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.